tomorrow with fireworks and backyard barbecues. Others will spend the day in reflection. 9 News reporter Ward Lucas has some words about the meaning of this holiday.
It was 55 years ago, and life was just beginning for a little boy named Matthew. In his 4 short years, all he ever knew was Mom and Daddy and a big red dog named Winkin. Daddy wore a uniform to work. It made him special. Matthew couldn't really explain why. He often heard words like duty and honor. Then one day, that uniform took Daddy to a strange country half a world away. All Matthew knew was that people were angry and fighting. But Daddy promised he'd be back. Matthew believed and waited. Harder still was a late-night knock on the door, Mom's cry of anguish, and a telegram that began, "We regret to inform you that..." Over the months and years, Mom tried to explain. Again and again, she opened a tattered newspaper photograph of the place where Daddy was. Sometimes, Matthew would open the letter from 2 of Daddy's friends. The letter said they visited him once in that far-off land and left a wreath on a place called Plot TT, Row 23. Such mysterious words. An ancient book of wisdom says it's the nature of life to die and be recreated. And so our sons grow up and have sons and daughters of their own. We wonder, is this the generation that will finally not have to send its children away for duty and honor? All these years later, how do we explain to the young the concept of Independence Day? Independence? From what? Perhaps all we can do is recall the story of a little boy named Matthew, 5 and a half decades ago, who had to grow up too soon. This is Ward Lucas, 9 News.
Matthew, by the way, is a real person. He is Ward's older half-brother. Matthew's first father was killed in battle in Belgium on Christmas Eve, 1944.